In this video, we'll talk a bit about how you can manually manipulate an OpenVSP design variable file and then automatically load that into an existing model. Now, this is a bit more of an advanced interaction with VSP than we would normally get into at this level, but what the heck, let's have some fun. So you can see I already have an example design variable file pulled up, and I have changed our old values from 10 and 20 to 5 and 15 for the root chord and the span for that test aircraft. And the way that you can load this in automatically when you launch a new OpenVSP model is you can do it from the command prompt. Now, from the command prompt, if you're wherever your VSP program is, you type VSP-help, it gets this message. So it tells you some extra options that are available to you in the command line, like running a script directly from the command prompt or implementing design files. And so the way that we can do this is I'm going to run VSP, give it the file name that we had before, tell it to execute a design file and use this one. So instead of having 10 for the root chord and 20 for the span, we're going to use a root chord of 5 and a span of 15. So watch what happens. I'm going to execute this. It's going to bring up a new OpenVSP GUI. And just like we told it to, if we look at the section on the wing, our span is 15, our root chord is 5. Now, that works each time that you want to automatically update. So if you want to run, say, OpenVSP headless and not use the GUI at all, you can do this same thing and then tell it to save the model, and you never have to bother with the GUI. It will run almost instantly. So this is a very quick way of implementing design variables and then saving it out to, say, a new model. So this is the type of stuff that you need to keep in mind when you're doing very complex trade studies and you need to manipulate several variables at once. You can either go in and do things in the VSP script where you're directly modifying things either through the API or through a VSP script, or you can simply alter the DES file, load it, do what you need to do, and get back out. So there are several different ways to make this process very, very quick, depending on what it is you want to do with it.